Welcome back to the channel. So we have another great article here. I will leave it in the description down below so you guys could check it out. T-Mobile users in Rappahannock, I hope I said that right, report issues with phone service for several months. So I just want to read a brief paragraph here. Rappahannock County residents are reporting phone service issues with provider T-Mobile over the past several months as the cell tower transitions to 5G. So the reason I wanted to make this is, partially as part of a PSA, because I've experienced these issues. Several other people have told me about these issues. So as T-Mobile is transitioning and integrating, there are several other issues, not only just the site itself, but as they transition to voice over NR, as they transition over to the standalone site, all of that brings issues. There's always downtime. I've seen it to where a Sprint site was converted over to T-Mobile and they had transport issues, which is backhaul, for several months. They had to apply brand new backhaul to the site, which of course takes permitting and everything else, to where the site wasn't operating properly and it wasn't even being optimized due to the fact that it had issues. So then they had to apply the new transport, then they optimized it, and then about 30 to 60 days after that took place, the site started operating normally. It started pushing the range that it can do. We started seeing 3, 4, 500 megabits a second. Before, it was like 50, 60. That site previously had, didn't have the best backhaul under Sprint, and it was very apparent right off the bat. So T-Mobile had to fix that. And then there's other, like I said, there's other things that the techs are doing right now. They're aggressively transitioning to the standalone core. And it's just causing issues on the site overall. You know, there's issues on LTE. It brings other issues on calling. And the root metrics reports are revealing those issues. Calling scores are going down for T-Mobile because, they're turning off the site. They're rebooting the site. They're tweaking, they're optimizing. And that's only supposed to happen during the nighttime where they have the servicing hours. Between certain hours they service the sites, and they usually do it at night to keep so consumers have the least amount of issues, because there's not a lot of traffic at that time. But now you got fixed wireless access that are gonna feel these issues. You got regular mobile consumers that are gonna sense these issues. So it's really just a punch that you have to take as T-Mobile in the gut, because it might create some churn for you that you may have otherwise not accounted for. But, what I've noticed too, once these issues are fixed on a site-by-site basis, it tends to work normal again, and in some cases even better for the area, right? Especially if it's a Sprint Keep site, that's even more better. So let me know if you've experienced these issues. I have. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. I've experienced these issues, and I've definitely, felt that pain too. So just pointing that out. So make sure you guys stay tuned to the channel. Like, share, subscribe, follow my social media outlets. This is Tyrone with Tech Life, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.